नमस्ते श्रीमात्रे नमः। देर वॉज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग पॉइंट दैट आई केम अक्रॉस। Which was more or less talking about the proper gurus, guru and acharya definition. Here is very interesting point. I really think if I take Lalita Sahasranama into consideration and the very concept of Traya Guru. Gurutrayas, which is there in Guru Mandala of Lalita Sahasranama. And interestingly, a very interesting point rather, it has to be a highly debatable point which one can really look at. The point is, why interesting I told was this Gurutrayas in Guru Mandala interestingly pinpoint to the Guru and Acharya concept. However, this Guru and Acharya concept has had its own developments over a period of time, over a period of centuries, as the centuries passed by, nevertheless. And I tried to get in touch with a few dance teachers, a few scholars in Vedas and Upanishads, and I tried to talk to them and understand the very meaning of Guru and Acharya concept. And interestingly, if we see Shankaracharya or Paramacharya, Parama plus Acharya, Shankara plus Acharya, like this, if we see gurus, they never propitiated themselves as gurus. Though they had that scholarly and that scholastic, highest level of scholastic knowledge to the best level, wherein it requires utmost surrendering. And interestingly, this has been told in Lalita Sahasranama in Guru Mandala. That is one more very vital point which one should be understanding. These Gurutrayas had three gurus. One is Lopamudra and other is Agastya and other is Srinadha. Now, one may ask, why am I talking about Gurutrayas when it comes to cross-reference to Guru and Acharya definition? Yes, it is very important to be understood. Now, most commonly, if we really see classical dance or classical music, directly or indirectly, it is taking us to a place where it takes to the Sahasrara state, which is again Kameshwara and Kameshwari state of mind, where one gets culminated. This has to be understood. This is first very basic point. Now, if I am talking about this, to reach to that level, what is the process that you need to follow is what matters, right? That's where you need to understand the yaga part. They are Bahiryaga, Antaryaga and Mahayaga. Mahayaga again is a concept. Again, Mahayaga concept comes when when you are thoroughly understanding the Antaryaga, and then you have mastered that Antaryaga, then comes the Bahiryaga. Vice versa, again, Bahiryaga, if you are thorough with Bahiryaga, wherein you are taking the form, you are considering the form God, God in the form. In Antaryaga, you are taking that formless God. That leads to the, again, the very concept of godly nature existing in everything, both form and formless. We need to understand this to the level. And once this has been reached, that's when this so-called guru will be in a realized state of mind. Guru is a realized state of mind which one needs to understand. It's a very easy concept, very easy concept to be understood. Yet again, not as easy as one thinks, because you have to practice both Antaryaga and Bahiryaga. There is a very beautiful question one of the scholar asked about yaga. What is the difference between yaga and yajna? The point is, Antaryaga and Bahiryaga are two very different concepts. Antaryaga requires understanding of the formed nature first. Only then you can think of what you call Antaryaga. Bahiryaga requires understanding the formed nature of God. Now, the real question is, this Antaryaga, Bahiryaga and Mahayaga concept, which is very much existing in the classical dance form and classical music, directly or indirectly. It's a very interesting point that one needs to really understand. Believe me. And only then he can go to the state of guru. Guru here means, guru means the dark side of the knowledge, coming out of the dark side of knowledge. Ru means the brightest side of the knowledge. Understand this. There is a very thin line that divides between guru and acharya. Acharya again, he will definitely know about the guru concept, and he will give somehow the very basic tips to actually like sorry about that, to very, you know, get to the understanding of propitiating and giving them the correct knowledge there. But guru does an all-round show. He engulfs everything, and that's when he gets to that state. And very interestingly, what I see is today's individuals, not only from the classical dance form, not only from the yoga teachers, not only from what you call Vedic practitioners, all these youngsters have started adding guru, 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 guru. My point is, has these so-called gurus who are adding guru tag to their name, of course, they may have earned PhDs or whatever it is. That is not a point for me. The point for me is, these PhDs and all, Shankaracharya and Madhvacharya and other seers have crossed, gone beyond PhDs. I don't really care about that. The point is, the reason for telling I don't care about that is, we need to really look at, you know, the very point of, you know, going beyond the plane. That's when you reach that guru status. My point is, how can one add guru tag to their names, irrespective of their performances, irrespective of their whatever knowledge they have gained? That's their greatness, or that is their achievement. I don't agree. I do agree to that. It's not that I don't agree to a point that, you know, they have achieved PhD and they need to have that guru tag. I don't agree to that, if you ask me. Guru is a very wider concept. After going through Lalita Sahasranama and understanding the Guru Mandala, I could understand that small, subtler difference of this very aspect of guru is what makes that difference. Acharya, again, he is no less what you call greater than guru. Acharya is also having his own place, because to become an acharya, one needs to put certain practices in place. What acharya means? Achara iti acharya. Understand this. Achara iti. Iti means, here again, practicing the old set philosophies, or practicing the old practices in order to establish that Sanatana Dharma concept. Guru also does that, interestingly, but at a larger scale. Acharya does it at a lower scale. When I say lower scale, doesn't mean slightly. It's like a thin line that divides. Now this is an open-ended question to all the professionals, teachers, PhD holders. If they have crossed that boundaries, think about it. It's $100 billion question. I have nothing against, like, you know, let them have that guru tag, let them have that acharya tag or whatever it is. But I just wanted to explain this Gurutraya concept, that is like Lopamudra, Agastya and Srinadha's understanding. And Antaryaga, Bahiryaga and Mahayaga have the so-called gurus who are holding PhD. Practiced this. However, note and disclaimer, exceptions are always there. I am not demeaning anyone over here. I just want to give the exact meaning of what really it means. Think about it. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. Guru's grace be with all. Have a nice day.